Good morning, everyone, and good morning, Advent. Good morning, everyone. Today is December 7th, and it's our second Tuesday of 2021 Advent devotion, Good Morning, Advent. Currently, we are talking about tears in the various Bible passages, so if you can focus on that word, tears, it will give you another insight on the Word of God. My hope and prayer is that this devotion will let you see God in your life more and let your heart be more prepared for the coming of Jesus Christ. Then, let's get started. Tuesday, Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 1 through 12. Again, I saw all the oppressions that are practiced under the sun. Look, the tears of the oppressed, with no one to comfort them. On the side of their oppressors, there was power, with no one to comfort them. And I thought the dead, who have already died, more fortunate than the living, who are still alive. But better than both is the one who has not yet been and has not seen the evil deeds that are done under the sun. Then I saw that all toil and all skill in work come from one person's envy of another. This also is vanity and a chasing after wind. Fools fold their hands and consume their own flesh. Better is a handful with quiet than two handfuls with toil and a chasing after wind. Again, I saw vanity under the sun, the case of solitary individuals without sons and brothers. Yet there's no end to all their toil, and their eyes are never satisfied with riches. For whom am I toiling, they ask, and depriving myself of pleasure? This also is vanity and an unhappy business. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up the other. But woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help. Again, if two lie together, they keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? And though one might prevail against another, two will withstand one. A threefold cord is not quickly broken. Amen. Tears of the oppressed. The tears of the oppressed run through the streets. Despair grows with justice denied. Unrest rises with inequities left intact for centuries. The tears of the oppressed represent not just sorrow and suffering, but righteous anger that will not be silenced forever. The global pandemic of 2020 brought with it waves of tears. Tears of mourning for the dead buried without the full rituals of funerals. Tears of anxiety when layoffs reverberated across the land. Tears of fear for those without access to health care. Then, 2 months into the health crisis, came the murder of George Floyd and halving of a nation that followed. The oppressed wept publicly, and no longer could the source of their pain be denied. Jesus' earthly ministry begins with the visit to his home faith community and his subsequent rejection by his own people. He stands in the synagogue on the Sabbath and reads from the prophet Isaiah, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And all who knew him best are filled with pride and affirmation until he interprets the text and tells his own people that they may in fact not be the ones for whom this is good news. He calls them out, calls them to account, compels them to look at themselves and ask if they are indeed the ones in need of release or the ones holding others captive. Needless to say, the congregation responds with indignation, anger, running him out and pushing him to the brink of a cliff. Not exactly a resoundingly successful start to the Savior's ministry. This Jesus on whom we wait this Advent season brings good news of great joy for all people, and this means that the tears of the oppressed will not go unseen, unheard, uncomforted. The one who comes to proclaim release to the captives will no doubt anger the people who benefit from the captivity. Good news for the poor entails a redistribution of wealth and power, and this kind of justice does not come without great resistance. The question those of us anticipating Emmanuel must ask ourselves is this: are we willing to participate in the good news of great joy for all people, even if it costs us something? If we are those in power, will we, for the sake of our Lord, join our cries with those of the oppressed and work for the justice that rolls like a roaring water, washing away the tears of our siblings too long left without comfort? We must not forget that the infant for whom we wait is the Messiah who brings good news to the poor, the ascended Lord who judges between those who cared for the least of these or not, the returning risen Christ who comforts the oppressed. Questions for reflection. 1. Read the headlines today. Where are the oppressed crying, and how are they being comforted or not? 2. How is Jesus coming good news for all people? How does this good news for all people impact the choices you make, how you treat others? 3. What is our Christian responsibility to responding to the tears of the oppressed? Prayer for the day. Let us pray together. Lord, we see your children, our siblings, crying in the streets for justice. The tears of the oppressed water the way of those too long denied comfort, equity, and abundant life. Our Savior comes to release the captives and bring relief to those who suffer. As we make ready for his birth, may our preparations be sacrificial, not superficial. May we weep with those who weep and work for a way of life together that reflects your good news of great joy for all people. Do not let us be among those who reject Jesus because our desire for power outweighs our love of you and our neighbors. Amen. Thank you for joining this morning, and I hope to meet you tomorrow again. God bless you, and have a wonderful day. Bye.